The overriding concept of the house is a couple things. I think first and foremost is our material choice of concrete, which stemmed from the idea of thermal mass and thermal inertia, allowing the house to not have wide temperature swings, which plays into the idea of sustainability and green technology.
Concrete lasts a lot longer than any type of construction that's available to us now. There's no painting, there's no fixing cracks or joints. In general, the maintenance long term that you have to do for the home is less than it would be than your typical wood frame construction.
When we started to think about sustainability and green technology, we wanted to take the functional criteria of what it means to be sustainable and green. And how do we make an architecture based on the functional criteria for those things? So in other words, optimal solar angles for the solar array, roof area for water, gray water collection and gray water reuse. And what we came up with was an inverted hip shape roof.
The roof is a key component that really sets this house apart from the visual aesthetic of a typical house. And the roof is mostly what gives this house its character. The photovoltaics are hidden from view, especially from the front entry, and the rest of the roof is even designed for optimum solar collection and also for rainwater collection. Like the roof, the rest of the house is also designed for very specific performance criteria, and that's where most of the aesthetic of the house comes from, is an attempt to be sustainable in every way that we can.
One design strategy we wanted to incorporate into this house was the fact that everything in the home has a dual purpose. So a hallway is not just a hallway. A closet is not just a closet. For example, our main closet space is storage, laundry, and an office space. So that was one of the things we really wanted to incorporate into the design. Another example of that is our living, dining, and kitchen. Since it's a small home, you have everything centralized right in one core and readily available to you as you need it. The indoor-outdoor connections, what we wanted to do is, since all of our circulation is centralized around a central core, you can move in and throughout the house freely, as well as in and throughout the landscape, which then ties, you know, the indoor and outdoor together.
A lot of what our house is getting at is ambient effects to make the house seem a little bit more comfortable. And so all the perforations have the same kind of diffuse glow. There's a translucent film on the outside, wide of the concrete. And that way you don't have a direct line of sight in or out of the house, so you're not, you know, affording any sort of privacy. But you're letting in ambient glow, which will offer ambient light to the inside of the house without any sort of thermal bridging.
The house will stand out on a block of other houses entirely unlike it, but what it stands for is very important, where we want to see the future of the building over the next 20, 50, 100 years.